The man who monitors the media 24/7, Phil Mattingly, said he was unaware of these reports that there have been attacks and assaults and insulting of people in the minority. Interesting. All right, let's bring in President and CEO of Endeavor Strategies, Kurt Bardella. Now, Kurt worked as a media consultant for Breitbart News before cutting ties earlier this year, and CNN political commentator and former Reagan White House political director Jeffrey Lord. Jeffrey, later on I'll call you and we can discuss how Roe v. Wade isn't settled law for the president-elect, but gay marriage is. I want to talk to you about that, but that's a discussion for guys like us. Kurt Bardella. There are words being used to describe Bannon, that he represents the Republican fringe. I would say that that's untrue. There are many Republicans, in fact, there are a few who want to own Steve Bannon and his politics, and that what comes out of Breitbart often plays on what's called tropes by the media. I would argue they are not tropes. These are often at least deceptive and often hateful headlines to drive separation in our society. You worked for them. Why, and what did you learn when you were there?
Well, I think that they represent a worldview that is incredibly dangerous and divisive, and to have this kind of proximity to the White House. I mean, Breitbart's gone from being the propaganda arm of the Trump campaign to now being the propaganda arm of the federal government, essentially, in a Trump White House. And I think that should be very concerning to all Americans right now, because any day that you look at their site, it's about one perspective, one agenda, and it's completely devoid of reality and facts. And it's all about speaking the worst divisions amongst the American people and their worst fears to try to advance a very narrow-minded agenda that's designed to just create conflict, and in this case, to prop up their straw man, Donald Trump.
Well, a big part of that is just politics, right? You win, you get to advance your view of reality. That's okay. And the left has done it and the right has done it. But I'm trying to find out if this guy's as different as I believe he is. You have that his wife in 2007 said that he didn't want his girls to go to a certain school because too many Jews there. Didn't want his kids the way the Jews raised their kids. Now, that's what she said. He said it's not true. But he has a reputation for trying to go after people as an attack person more than an ideological person. Can you square any of that with your own experience?
Well, there's no doubt that Steve is a very aggressive, attack-oriented, move forward, never back down, never apologize, never show any sign of weakness. That's his entire, modus operandi, if you will. And, never before have we had someone who is basically the co-White House chief of staff, the co-virtual president, in a position like this to wield tremendous influence and have the ability to advance any type of offensive he wants to run against anybody he believes is a threat or a problem for the administration.
Jeffrey, James Baker, you likened Steve Bannon to James Baker. Baker.
Chris, I likened Reince Priebus James Baker.
All right, that's good. Then I'm fine with that. Let's leave it alone. How do you feel about Bannon?
I think he's been smeared, to be perfectly candid. I read Breitbart every day. They're death on diversity politics, when diversity politics, from my point of view, as you know, is absolute racism. The culture of racism at the core of the Democratic Party for 200 years and the American left has been normalized, to use the word you were using a few minutes ago, that it's okay to divide people by race. It isn't. That's what the American left does. Bannon is opposed. Good for him.
Except, and what you just said, and by the way, look, the way you just said it is fine. People will agree, they'll disagree. But what Breitbart does, whether they're targeting me or they're targeting other people in the media, is they deceive, they distort context, and they do it to advance an agenda that the media is against you, and that everything is the left, and that the system is the left, and that this is about a race war, and about white America being put down. And now you have that guy in the White House speaking for all Americans. Is that good?
Chris, I mean, I just disagree totally with your picture of Steve Bannon. I mean, I read Breitbart every day. I mean, it's conservative. I mean, you're not going to hear much difference out of Breitbart than you are from Rush Limbaugh.
You think that Rush Limbaugh would be a good guy to have as a president's top strategist, with him spending all of his time trying to divide this country?
Well, Chris, here's the trick that the left always plays, and you just, my friend, played it, is that you guys divide Americans all of the time the Obama administration and the American left divide people by race, and then they pretend that it's all normal. It's not normal.
Yeah, but then you got
it's
people like you, Jeffrey, who divide by line.
All right, Jeffrey, I got your point. Kurt, make your point, because I didn't understand it. What would you say?
You talk about divisiveness. The divisiveness comes from people like Jeffrey, who go on TV every single day and flat out lie to the American people and are completely devoid of what's actually happening and what's reality. I'll tell you what's really happening. The first thing Donald Trump does, basically, is go on Twitter and advance a lie about the New York Times under subscription rates. No fact. It turns out to be untrue. We're never going to hear him back that down and say, you know what, I got that wrong. I shouldn't have done it. What about the fact that the president, one of the first things he wants to do is attack the media, attack the free press? That is one of the most dangerous things